Thank you.
Hello, can you hear me now? All right. So I'll use a whisk here. You have to slowly. You have to keep whisking it so that it becomes soft and creamy and fluffy. It's difficult when you do manually, but we are used to using KitchenAid and all. So, but anyway, you keep whisking it at the same time. I'll be there. So while the icing sugar and butter being whisked, I will use all the dry ingredients. So dry ingredients, you can mix it together. So this is refined flour. So the whisking is very important, like, you know, basically to incorporate air. So when you see your cakes are nice and fluffy, so you know, because of the good whisking, because the aeration that happens into the bakery product, and it rises, right? And also the function of the baking powder or baking soda also helps it. But whisking is very important so that the blending is mixed properly, the icing sugar and the butter is emulsified well. So I'll use all the dry ingredients. There is flour. This is almond flour. This is baking powder. Then we have cocoa powder. And a little bit of sea salt. I've used unsalted butter here, so I'm using sea salt here. And this can microwave, microcontroller. So basically, you can just mix all the ingredients, all the dry ingredients. So this is nice and creamy and fluffy. So here I'm using a little bit of chocolate, melted chocolate. Can you melt? This is working, right?
I don't know.
Just hang on, I just melt the chocolate and add. It'll take some time. Fine, it's melting. So once the chocolate is melted, I'll add the chocolate to it. It gives you much more. I'm using chocolate also because it gives you a good taste to your breton. When you have it, you get a rich chocolate taste. The chocolate I'm using is Ecuador. It's one of the single origin chocolate, Calibu. It's one of the best chocolate in the world. And when you say single origin, I hope you understand what it is. It's basically like wine comes from different region, right? And you have a specific grape to make a wine. Here in cocoa industry also, they have region where they go the cocoa pods, and the seeds from that particular region are made in chocolate. So I'm using 70% a very rich dark chocolate called Ecuador, and it gives a nice flavor and taste to your product. So I'll add a little bit of chocolate to it. So you mix the chocolate along with the icing sugar and butter like this. Then you add all the dry ingredients, right? I can give the dry ingredients. Slowly,
two at a time.
Just use a cut and fold method so that it mix slowly. At the same time, you have to understand that the aeration what you have done with the whisking should not go away. So you don't over mix it, just lightly fold it. Yeah, you should use part by part. What happens, you know, if you add one together, together, you have to whisk it to mix it. So there you fail because all the aeration goes down and becomes a big lump. So if you can see now when you mix, it's like it's blending well. So bakery pastry is an area where you have a lot of patience, it takes a lot of time, but you have to always think of the end product, what you do, end product has to be right, so the process has to be correct, it's very recipe based, so whatever recipe you have to follow it perfectly. Right. So if you see your batter is ready, that the mixture for the breton is ready, but this has to be kept in the fridge almost maybe half an hour, 45 minutes to set before we roll it out. So that time we don't have here. Basically, you have a rolling pin, obviously, you have a, and if you have oven, on a silk pad, silicone mat or a baking paper, you roll it maybe 1 centimeter thick, and I've used a mold. So after you bake it, this is what you get. So this becomes my base for the recipe, all right? And like you see, you roll it, you can use any type of cutter. I have used a square mold here. It can be oval, it can be rectangle, any fancy mold can do, but it has to be a cutter with, and while baking a sablé breton, it's a very delicate. You just cannot roll it and put it in the oven like cookies. No, you cannot. It has to have a circumference which will hold the thing and it will rise so that you get a nice texture and a proper shape. So this you can keep it aside. So so what you do, to keep it in the fridge, don't keep it like in a bowl like this. You have a cling wrap. You put the cling wrap, put the mixture, put the cling wrap and flat it up so that when you're taking out and rolling it, easier for you to roll. If you keep it in a lump like this, what happens, you know, it takes time to thaw and you start kneading with your hand and that will take out the aeration. It becomes very, when you bite into it, it will not be nice. The texture is not nice. So ideally, this is the way you should store it. Not more than 30 minutes, just to cool it down, roll it, use a cutter and bake it at 180 degrees centigrade for maybe 15 to 20 minutes. That's it. So this I'll keep it aside. Okay, next I'll tell you about this ganache, Belgium chocolate ganache. If you go to Belgium, a lot of stores are there. They are very famous for selling Belgium ganache chocolates, which are rolled either in cocoa powder or chocolate flakes, dark, white, milk, plenty. Now with rubies and gold. So a lot of things are there. But this is a very simple recipe. It can be done at home very easily. It's just butter and chocolate and flavoring. So it's very rich. I know the health conscious people will not like it, but they will eat this. They don't want to miss it. So I really enjoy this recipe a lot. And to showcase in a demo like this, it's very easy to make and show it to you. Here I'll be using Coentro, is a orange liqueur, and it goes very well with this 70% liquido. So this is, so I have the chocolate. I need a bowl to melt now. It might be melt. Isko khali karte hain. Then empty that here. Wipe karke micro karte hain. Here again, the butter has to be softened. इसको वाइप कर। सो द रेसिपी सेज 250 ग्राम बटर, 60 ग्राम फॉन्डेंट, आई डोंट हैव इट हियर, फॉन्डेंट इज अ लिक्विड फॉन्डेंट विच यू यूज, बट इट्स ऑप्शनल, इफ यू डोंट हैव नो प्रॉब्लम, लाइक इट रियली होल्ड्स द गनाश वेल, बट हियर बटर एंड आई एम यूजिंग 60-70% चॉकलेट, सो इट विल होल्ड, सो नो वरी ऑन दैट, एंड आई यूज अ फ्लेवरिंग कॉल कॉइन थ्रू। इट्स वेरी सिंपल, यू विस द बटर नाइसली, एड द मेल्टेड चॉकलेट, या परफेक्ट, इसे मेल्ट कर दें, ये जाएगा अंदर, ओवन कर दो जाएगा, so I'll be melting the chocolate in the micro, but be very careful, you can't leave the chocolate to melt in the micro on its own, and you have to keep stirring in between, otherwise chocolate will burn, because chocolate melts at 45 degrees centigrade, and if you don't take care of that, it will get burnt and it will spoil the whole chocolate, so this will take little time. In the meantime, I'll while the chocolate is melting, I'll go to the third recipe, which is caramel ganache. Caramel ganache is again cashew sugar, butter, cream, sea salt and milk, which is a sea salt caramel, so I'm using sea salt here, and milk chocolate. So I'll be needing an induction pan for this. So the method is prepare caramel with the sugar. I'll take the caramel. I will make the caramel with the sugar. So once the sugar is like golden brown color and the sugar is melted evenly, I'll tell you there's few tricks there to melt sugar. It's a chemical agent where you don't stir much. You just let it melt on its own. Otherwise, there are lumps and crystal forms in between. So you caramel the sugar, you add the cream in parts so that cream gets incorporated well with the caramel, and then you add the sea salt, and then you add the cream to it, add the butter to it, and finally the chocolate. And this you keep it aside. It's again, it's a ganache kind of texture, which you have to store overnight. Either, and it should be stored in a, not inside the refrigerator, because it becomes very hard. In a normal room temperature, if you store it, it stays well, and next day it crystallizes, which you can use as a filling for the pralines. This is a very good filling for a pralines. Pralines are bonbons, like the, you line the mold with chocolate, and then you do a filling and close it, like you get pralines and bonbons, what you get to eat. And this is can be made separately, like Belgium ganache also. If you make the ganache, you pipe it, you put it in the fridge, take it out, it becomes a little hard. So what you do, you have your chocolate flakes, you have your different kind of garnishes, you just roll it in your hand, dip it in a chocolate, and just roll it in the chocolate flakes and all. And that is amazing, like you can dust with cocoa powder, icing sugar, whatever decoration you will do, you can do that. So there's a reason I've taken this recipe. I will show you one dessert kind of thing, and this can be used in various ways. So for the caramel ganache, I'll just take the sugar. Yeah, melt hona dheere. So isko le le, isko le le. Ha, isko milate hain abhi. इसको ऑन करें भाई, हाँ स्टोरी का, सी व्हाट हैपेंस, यू नो व्हेन यू मेल्ट चॉकलेट, हाफ विल मेल्ट, हाफ विल नॉट मेल्ट, सो यू कीप स्टरिंग इट एंड पुट इट बैक इनटू द माइक्रो, बिकॉज ऑफ द कैलेट्स इट विल मेल्ट फास्ट, बट इसको ऑन कर दे, ये ऑन है,
ऑन है, ऑन है,
39 में melt completely. Make sure it's the chocolate is melted completely. Yeah, it's coming right. Is
इसको थोड़ा सा.
दिस इज़ फॉर द बेल्जियम गनाश. तो द बटर हैज़ टू बी वेस्ट.
ये हो नहीं रहा यार.
So for the Belgium ganache also, if you have a KitchenAid at home, it's easy, faster, nice and fluffy, your butter becomes, then you add the chocolate to it.
This is taking time, eh? Should I do it, sir?
So you keep stirring the chocolate because already hot. But make sure there's no lumps to it.
I think ek baar thoda
cover kar lo. Haan. If you're doing with your hand, make sure the butter is room temperature, nice and soft. For it will be easy for you to mix the chocolate into it. I think it's taking a little time, you should have patience a little bit. Ye hai kare.
Now I do. Our butter is this, you can see soft peaks.
Yeah, this is nice and soft peak. You have to use a little of energy here, but yeah, you can get it done.
This was the
yeah, this for the sugar is still taking some time to that is done. Yeah, perfect. Watch out. Yeah, this I'll do. Just try to melt this kernel. So here for the Belgium ganache, I have. Going through here, chocolate is nice and melted, okay. But here you have to be, here you have to be a little careful. Like you know, now the temperature of chocolate is almost 45 degree, you know, 40-45. But if I just directly put it in the the butter, the whole thing will melt. So then you don't have that aeration. So I'll just wait for a little bit for the temperature to come down to at least 35, okay. So you have a thermometer which you get is a probe thermometer, very simple equipment. When you playing with chocolate, this is very important tool. So to know the temperature of your chocolate. Yeah, don't. So this I was worried about. Anyway, no problem. So you should not stir the sugar too much. If you stir, there's a lot of lumps happen. You just let it melt on its own. You just toss the pan. That's it. The less you handle sugar, it's better. So it's almost 42 degree. So I'll just bring the temperature down a little bit by just.
Nice.
Yeah, I mean. If you want to feel the flavor, they can feel the flavor.
Afterwards,
like you know, you can. It's a very rich dark chocolate, but very smooth. Yeah.
इसको खोल दो,
मेकिंग कैरमल इज बिट ट्रिकी, इट्स बिकॉज द टेम्परेचर इज वेरी हाई एंड यू टू वेरी केयरफुल वेन हैंडलिंग कैरमल. It has to be nice golden color, it should not get burned or over caramelized. So this I'll leave it for some time, let the temperature come down, then I'll add it. So this I was talking about the lumps, because my friend he stirred it without knowing, no problem.
Okay, sorry.
Yeah, it's okay. So the good that it happened, so I can show you the fault in it. So this will take little time to melt. So you can always, when it's caramelizing, you should go off the flame, just to make sure the lumps are melted well. See, if it is still light color, I'll wait for the color to come a little bit more. So when you to check the color of the caramel, you can always see it like this. See, it's still light in color. I'll wait for a little more to get the right color, which has to be nice and golden. Once the caramel melts completely, the sugar melts completely, then you can stir it. It's getting better. So now is the time you can add the cream. Like I said, add the cream in parts. So you blend the cream and the caramel together, it becomes a toffee sauce kind of thing effect. Okay.
All the participants,
this is the butter.
Who are currently preparing their,
then you can add the butter.
You have only 5 minutes left. I request all the judges to please come and take the place, because in the next 5 minutes we're going to start with their presentation and the tasting of their main course dishes. All the young chefs who are currently in the fourth round of the culinary chef competition.
Can you pour it somewhere?
No, get ready. This is the next 5 minutes. You're
going to
come
pour it in a bowl. Not required also. So once the butter also gets incorporated well, you have the chocolate. Chocolate is a milk chocolate. I've used again a single origin chocolate called Ariba. It's again a single origin chocolate from Calibu. So once you add the chocolate, इसको बंद कर ऑफ कर दें. एक तो गिव मी अ बोल, गिव मी अ बोल. सो दिस basically you need to whisk a bit to blend it well. If you have a hand blender, it's very good. You take a long beaker or a jug, and you put the ganache and blend it. Once you blend it, the emulsification happens very well and a lot of aeration happens, and I'll put it there.
मैंने पोर सम वाटर
यो बिस्क मिक्स था ना यहाँ पे
एक ही था सर वो बटर
सो योर गनाश इज मोर लाइक अ लिक्विड नाउ इट्स वेरी हॉट यू लीव द या I'll whisk it a little bit more to blend it. So this is your ganache. It has to be cool, so you leave it in the room temperature outside, and the texture next day becomes very like a toffee, which can be used. I'll be using as open piping. I'll use it like that. But you can use it for filling your chocolates, you know, for filling bonbons or pralines, you can use that, right? I think this is also ready, the Belgium ganache, I'll make it. Just can you pour the chocolate to this? So once the chocolate is nice and it's cool, we'll add it to the, put the whole thing.
Whole thing? Slowly I'll have
it. Now done. That's enough. So you see, it's a nice creamy texture you get. Once you, that's perfect. So this is the flavoring, coriander, rum, single malt, anything you can use. And natural flavoring also you can use if you don't take alcohol. So this is your ganache, Belgium ganache, but at the moment it's little bit flowy, but you have to let it crystallize for some time in a AC condition, or if you put in the fridge for not more than 10-15 minutes so that it crystallizes and then easy to pipe. So coming to the presentation of the whole thing, I will just need a whisk butter, add the melted chocolate, add your flavorings, and this is what the ganache is. I've already brought it tempered, and the caramel ganache. So again, the caramel ganache, I just made the caramel with the sugar, add cream to it, add butter, add milk chocolate. So your ganache is ready. So after a day, the consistency is like this. See, nice and creamy. You can use it for your filling wherever you want. And this is the Belgium ganache. So I'll just do the finishing part now. Remove this. So you need a piping bag. I'm using a star nozzle and a plain nozzle. Yeah, use that. All right, here we go. All right. I have some freeze-dried strawberries. Some chocolate crumble. I've got some hazelnut also. You can use some hazelnut, it gives a nice crunch to your dessert. I have used orange, so I'll just use some dehydrated orange powder. A bit of cocoa powder, just a little bit. And we are calling it Millionaire Chocolate Tart. So I'll use some of 24 karat gold leaf, not 24 karat, just a edible gold leaf. And of course some crispy gold coated balls. All right, here we go, thank you. This is the dessert. It's called Millionaire's Chocolate Tart with caramel ganache and Belgium ganache. Thank you. Any questions you have? Anything? Sure, sure.
I came a little late.
All right.
So I don't know the base.
So the base is basically a chocolate bretard, a sablé base, which is made with flour, butter, icing sugar, almond flour, and cocoa powder. And also baking powder has been added. And basically you have to whisk, bake it.
Yeah.
It has to be crisp. So basically baking. No, it's a cookie dough kind of thing. It's a dough, but to get a proper shape, if you don't give a sides, you know, it will fall apart.
Okay.
So you have to have a ring, round, whatever, rectangle, oval, to get the whole thing right.
So you fight the chocolate ganache.
Yeah. No.
And then you fight the.
No. You make the chocolate ganache and the caramel separately.
Oh, they are two varieties.
Two different ganaches.
Okay.
So one is caramel ganache, one is Belgium ganache. So very easy to make. I mean, it's very fast.
In place of the shortcuts, we can use any biscuit.
Any kind of biscuit you can use. Ideally, it should be nice and texture should be good. It's easy to bite into it. So if I can you've taken the photograph? You've taken the picture? You can take the picture and then I'll cut and serve it to you. You can taste it. One second. So basically, yeah.
Thing.
Yeah, it's like a tart, basically tart. We call it Milliner's chocolate tart.
Yeah.
So ganache is something, no? It has to be this should be piped. So Belgium ganache is only chocolate and butter.
Yeah.
Moment you put in the fridge.
Chocolate and cream.
No, this is on Belgium ganache is only chocolate and butter. Whisk the butter soft and add the chocolate to it. So what happens, you know? Then you have to get this consistency to pipe it out. But if you're making, if you put in the fridge, what happens? It crystallizes. It's very difficult to get back to this stage. You have to remelt it. So the if you when you eat this, it's nice and fluffy in your mouth.
Right.
It will melt.
But if I make it before and I keep it in the fridge.
Yeah, it's better you leave it in a room temperature outside.
I see.
It sets.
Because it has no cream, it could be left out.
Yeah. What's the crumble?
Chocolate crumble.
See, chocolate crumble is very simple. It's like butter, icing sugar, cocoa powder. You mix in each equal quantity. You can try, ma'am. You can mix in equal quantity and you can have it. I hope you're liking the taste, I don't know.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, delicious. Please, yeah. All right, thank you so much. Please do the tasting. Yeah.